On October 15th, 1999, a film called Julian Donkey Boy was released by the director Harmony Korine. Harmony Korine was born January 4th, 1973, and is very much known for his style in film. His father is a tap dancer who made documentaries for PBS. He would take Harmony to carnivals and circuses often. He even taught him how to use a Bolex camera. He lived his childhood in a commune until he moved to New York to live with his grandmother. Some sources say he actually dropped out of Tisch to pursue a professional skateboarding career. Some of his notable films are Gummo, 1997, Spring Breakers, 2012, Kids, 1995, and The Beach Bum, 2019. He has won awards and nominees at festivals such as Venice, Film Independent Spirit Awards, and others. When it comes to the story of Julian Donkey Boy, that's the problem, because there is none. I guess the main takeaway from the film is how the effects of a disability can be on family life, especially when it's untreated. There's no dedication to following the ground plot. Is Julian Donkey Boy for me? No. Is it for you? Probably not. I understand what Harmony is trying to say and accomplish by breaking standards of filmmaking and pursuing a story not following techniques used in mainstream cinema. It was the longest hour of my life, but I can appreciate someone trying to break standards.
Mommy?
Hello, Julian?
Mommy!
Hi!
Hey, Mommy!
Hi!
Mommy, I can call you Mother.
Mom.
Yes.
Hi,
Julian.
Hi, Mom.
How are you?
I'm doing real good, Mom. I'm fine. I'm a lot better now.
Good.
Are you a dietitian still? Or are you a waitress?
No, I'm neither one now.
You were a cop. You were a traffic cop, like a female police officer of the law.
Nope. I'm a dentist now, Julian. I fix people's teeth when they're in pain.
What are you just a dentist? Did you go to law school?
No, I'm just a basic general dental practitioner. People come to see me when they have mouth pain or different sorts of ailments and different sorts of gum diseases.
I mean, you don't participate in any plastic surgery there?
No, sometimes when people smoke too frequently, their teeth get dirty, and me and my staff will whiten them with special dental tools.
What about my teeth, Mom? I got gold fronts. Chris got me some gold fronts. My little baby brother, he gave me some gold fronts for my birthday, Mom.
That was very nice of him.
Yeah, I can eat through apples and tabletops.
I don't believe you.
I love you, Mom. I miss you, Mom. I wish you were still here, like when I was a little baby, Mom.
Yes. I love you too, Julian. And I'm watching you. All those voices you're hearing, those are just friendly voices. No one's out to get you. No one wants to hurt you. Right? Julian?
I wish you were still here, Mom. Like when I was six, Mom. When I was six, you sent me for Jaka. When I was six, Pearl was four, man. Chris was just a little baby, Mom. Remember Chris, just a little baby.
Yep.
When he took you away in the hospital and he killed you dead. You remember him, Mom? Chris was just a little baby boy.
How are your teeth, Julian?
Well, they're okay. They're good.
You brushing daily?
Yeah.
You have to remember to brush in the crevices, in between the teeth, because that's where the majority of cavities arrive. And floss weekly. At least, at the minimum, you must floss once a week.
I promise. I will. I promise, Mom. I'll floss like when you were still alive. When you were still in the house, Mom, I'll floss before you were dead, Mom. I'll floss like that. I promise, Mom. Okay, I gotta go.
Okay.
I love you, Mom. I love you, Mom.
Okay.
I really love you. I love you soon, Mom. Okay, my best friend. Okay.
Okay. I love you too, Julian.
I love you too, Mom.
Take good care of your teeth, and you'll always be a happy person. Okay, Julian. Bye.
Mom.
Bye. Yes.
Bye, Mom.
Bye. Bye. I love you.
This is, in my opinion, the best scene in the film, yet you have to wait an entire hour to get to it. I believe the way the scene is shot actually adds to its delivery. In cinema, 90% of the time, you're gonna get that polished professional film look, but I think having the old VHS family home grainy mess of a screen actually adds to it. And I can appreciate it. It's a heartbreaking scene because you see this boy who is clearly not given the help he needs, as he talks to his sister who pretends to be his mother who passed away. It's truly the only moment in the film I actually leaned forward and enjoyed. Over the years, Harmony has given his films more of a polished look, but he seems to have continued to stick with his passion for film. He continues to do what he's always done with his vibrance and truly standout films. Granted, I'm obviously not the biggest fan of them, but I appreciate it so much. I love seeing such high-name actors agree to this absolute madman of a director. Why is it needed? I feel like I answered that already. Not many directors are brave enough to say fuck you to big studios like this guy, and honestly, I applaud his weirdness and I hope he never changes with his craft.